Hello and welcome back to Cautionary Global Financial Analysis. This is a comparison between the FAANGS stocks plus Microsoft and Salesforce, ticker symbol CRM is being added into the mix here, with an S being added to create the FAANGS. The stocks are Apple, Amazon, Salesforce, Facebook, Google, Microsoft, and Netflix. Now, we have five metrics in total here. The first two metrics are on a scale from 0 to 1, or alternatively 0 to 100%. So beginning with coverage, this is an estimate of the coverage of actual financing obligations, dividends, and debt repayments. So the cutoff in terms of the tier system that we have here, tiers or ranking system, the ranking system goes from 1 to 3, the top three tiers being 1, 2, and 3, with the strongest companies being in number one position. All the remainder are categorized as number four. On coverage here, the cutoff is at 0.50, so literally right in half here, or 50%. And you can see here, with the exception of Netflix, all of the companies far exceed that cutoff. They're almost all in the 90s, which is very high. Next is an exposure to a negative cash flow scenario. Now, the cutoff there is just under 8%, and all the companies with exception of Netflix make that grade. Next is, the last three here are, the estimates here are all in terms of cash flow as a percentage of revenues of the firm. So beginning with centrality, there is a cutoff established of greater than 9%. So that'd be somewhere, I'm gonna put it right around here. A greater than 9% is the desirable cutoff here. Now, Amazon and Netflix do not make that grade. The next is, actually these last two categories are the maximum acceptable exposure categories, 5% and 10%. These estimates here give us an idea of, in theory, of how much cash flow that they have to be able to cover financing obligations, given these specified maximum acceptable exposure levels of 5 or 10%. So just for instance, the cutoff actually for all of these is 5%. So let's put that somewhere right around here, straight across 5%, and it's not a straight line, sorry about that. But we see here that a number of companies do make the grade, the exceptions being Amazon here, Netflix on both accounts here, and then also Amazon here, as well as CRM. Now, CRM falls short in this one area here behind Amazon. Now the question might arise, well, if Salesforce is in negative territory here, which doesn't sound too good, then why is it so high in the coverage metric? And the reason for that is because this area here is capturing primarily the left tail of these cash flow distributions. And so anything that's in the negative here suggests that there's a fair number of outcomes that that fall into that negative territory in the left tail. So Netflix being, of course, a major example of that. When they fall in that negative territory, that actually means that there's no amount of financing obligations that can be covered by cash flows, because it's negative. Cash flows are negative. At that level of, or that specified maximum acceptable exposure level of either 5% or 10%. In closing, keep in mind that the estimates are preliminary and are not forecasts or predictions. See any further information in the links below the video. Thank you very much for listening.